In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
And also with you.
Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, "The first commandment is this, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is the only Lord. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this, Love your neighbour as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets." Amen. Lord, have mercy. Jesus gives rise to gossip by casting out demons from people. Many people are glad that the demons have been cast out, but other people question it, saying that it can only be by the prince of demons that he casts out demons. As we learned in Sunday's Gospel, Jesus can't get it right for anyone. And that's perhaps the way things are as human beings. Because of that, they then get harassed and dejected because they're not quite sure what's happening. They're listening to the gossip and they don't know which way to turn. So he has compassion on them, and he sets himself to teach them at great length. He isn't deterred, he carries on, because he knows the need they have to hear what he has to say. And so, as people today are confused at the lifting of the lockdown, as to whether the pandemic is still in full flow or not, all the various confusions which we obviously have, and those confusions we've always had which are not necessarily so obvious, as all these things are part of our lives, we can turn to the one who gives us clear teaching, who has compassion, and we can be compassionate in our turn and teach clearly in our turn. For the times when we have failed in such compassion, for the times when we have failed to listen to that teaching, for the times when we've even fallen for the gossip, let us ask God's forgiveness. Brothers and sisters in Christ, as we gather at the Lord's table, we must recall the promises and warnings given to us in the Scriptures. Let us therefore examine ourselves and repent of our sins. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you through our own fault, in thought and word and deed, and in what we have left undone. We are heartily sorry and repent of all our sins. For your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who in his great mercy has promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with heartfelt repentance and true faith turn to him, have mercy on you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Let us pray. O God, the protector of all who trust in you, without whom nothing is strong, nothing is holy, increase and multiply upon us your mercy, that with you as our ruler and guide we may so pass things. but not through me. They set up princes, but without my knowledge. With their silver and gold they made idols for their own destruction. Your calf is rejected, O Samaria. My anger burns against them. How long will they be incapable of innocence? For it is from Israel, an artisan made it. It is not God. The calf of Samaria should be broken to pieces, for they sow the wind, and they reap the whirlwind. The standing grain has no heads. It shall yield no meal. If it were to yield, foreigners would devour it. When Ephraim multiplied altars to expiate sin, they became to him altars for sinning. Though I write for him the multitude of my instructions, they are regarded as a strange thing. Though they offer choice sacrifices, though they eat flesh, the Lord does not accept them. Now he will remember their iniquity and punish their sins. They shall return to Egypt. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The Lord is full of compassion and mercy. The Lord is full of compassion and mercy. He will not always accuse us, neither will he keep his anger forever. He has not dealt with us according to our sins, nor rewarded us according to our wickedness. The Lord is full of compassion and mercy. For as the heavens are high above the earth, so great is his mercy upon those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far has he set our sins from us. The Lord is full of compassion and mercy. Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. Matthew. Glory to you. A demoniac who was mute was brought to Jesus, and when the demon had been cast out, the one who had been mute spoke, and the crowds were amazed and said, "Never has anything like this been seen in Israel." But the Pharisees said, "By the ruler of the demons he casts out the demons." Then Jesus went about all the cities and villages, teaching in their synagogues, and proclaiming the good news of the kingdom, and curing every disease and every sickness. When he saw the crowds, he had compassion for them, because they were harassed and helpless, like sheep without a shepherd. Then he said to his disciples, "The harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Therefore ask the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into his harvest." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
In the power of the Spirit and in union with Christ, let us pray to the Father. The Diocese of Derby, we are asked to pray today for the Haven Christian Centre in Littleover, and in the Anglican Communion cycle of prayer, we pray for the Diocese of Northwestern Australia in the Anglican Church of Australia, and for the Diocese of Awka and Kafanjan in the Anglican Church of Nigeria. Continue to pray for those in parts of the world where COVID-19 is still rampant, for the people of Brazil, for the townships of South Africa, for the people of Mozambique and other parts of sub-Saharan Africa where there is little in the way of medical facilities, of the opportunity to be distant from one another. We pray too for those who seek to be normal in a situation which is not normal, for those who fear to be out of the four walls they have been confined to, for those who have mental illnesses which have been exacerbated by the lockdown. As we pray for the sick, we remember Paul Taylor, Jane Stretton, Kenneth Hughes, Jane Austin, Charlize Kane, John Robinson, Robin Glass, Jean Knox, Laura, Sheila Laverick, Carol Kingham, John Lydgate, Ian McKenzie, David Staines, Jane Jackson, Teddy, June Franklin, John Herring, Jean Maiden, Sue Hastings, Patricia Mitchell, Michael Catton, and John Herring. And as we remember those who have gone before us in faith, we pray for Beryl Mead and David Wales, recently departed. For the peace of the whole world, for the welfare of the Holy Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For Libby, our bishop, for the leaders of our sister churches, and for all clergy and people, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For Elizabeth, our queen, for the leaders of the nations, and for all in authority, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For this community, for every city, town, and village, and for all the people who live within them, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For good weather, and for abundant harvests for all to share, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For those who travel by land, air, or water, for the sick and the suffering, for prisoners and captives, and for their safety, health, and salvation, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For our deliverance from all affliction, strife, and need, and for the absolution of our sins and offences, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. Remembering all who have gone before us in faith, and in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary and all the saints, we commit ourselves and one another and our whole life to Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. God is love, and those who live in love live in God, and God lives in them. Peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
the grain once scattered in the fields, and the grapes once dispersed on the hillside, are now reunited on this table in bread and wine. So, Lord, may your whole church soon be gathered together from the corners of the earth into your kingdom. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift our hands to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
Blessed are you, Lord God, our light and our salvation. To you be glory and praise forever. From the beginning you have created all things, and all your works echo the silent music of your praise. In the fullness of time you made us in your image, the crown of all creation. You give us breath and speech, but with angels and archangels and all the powers of heaven, we may find a voice to sing your praise. Holy, 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 Lord God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. How wonderful the work of your hands, O Lord. As a mother tenderly gathers her children, you embrace the people as your own. When they turned away and rebelled, your love remained steadfast. From them you raised up Jesus, our Saviour, born of Mary, to be the living bread in whom all our hungers are satisfied. He offered his life for sinners, and with a love stronger than death, he opened wide his arms on the cross. On the night before he died, he came to supper with his friends, and taking bread, he gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to them, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." We remember his dying and rising in glory, and we rejoice that he intercedes for us at your right hand. Pour out your Holy Spirit as we bring before you these gifts of your creation. May they be for us the body and the blood of your dear Son. As we eat and drink these holy things in your presence, form us in the likeness of Christ and build us into a living temple to your glory. Remember, Lord, your church in every land. Reveal her unity, guard her faith, and preserve her in peace. Bring us at the last with the Blessed Virgin Mary and all the saints to the vision of that eternal splendour for which you have created us through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom, with whom, and in whom, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise. Blessing and honour and glory and power be yours forever and ever. Amen. Jesus taught us to call God our Father, And so we have the courage to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body because we all share in one bread. Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, Redeemer of the world, grant us peace. Draw near with faith. Receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood which he shed for you. Eat and drink in remembrance that he died for you. And feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. We do not presume to come to this your table, merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness. In your manifold and great mercies, we are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under your table, but you are the same Lord, whose nature is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us. Amen. Grant, O Lord, we beseech you, that the course of this world may be so peaceably ordered by your governance, that your church may joyfully serve you in all godly quietness, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The peace of God which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ, and the blessing and the love of the Lord the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain